There's a sense of danger here. And it's really bad.
It's a desperate kind of feeling because you don't know anymore.
All this prejudice is starting to affect the way I feel about other people. I'm starting to be prejudiced.
They just like started hitting me like from all over and stuff.
It's so deep. I don't know if it could be turned around. So, you know, to help us.
Damn. These guys called me a spick. I thought it was done with that.
Prejudice can destroy hearts and minds for the young, for people of all ages. That's why in 1985, the Anti-Defamation League of B'nai B'rith introduced A World of Difference. Originally a one-year project in Boston, now an ongoing multi-year national project touching the lives of millions and reaching 30 major American cities by 1990. A World of Difference reaches people in many ways. In the classroom, through teacher training, through public seminars for community leaders, and by ADL's partnership with national television, where we have brought our agenda to over 30% of American households. Over $20 million of airtime has been devoted to A World of Difference by network-affiliated television. With the power of television, the ADL has entered a new era in the fight for a better America. Through carefully crafted public service announcements, documentaries, news stories, and high-quality primetime specials, people are challenged to examine their attitudes towards others.
You know what they're like. Dirty, lazy, never want to work. All they want is handouts.
Personal opinion is a freedom we all share. There's no law against saying how we feel. But what we say can influence those who listen, especially young minds who remember and learn from what they hear.
They look different anyway, and some of them don't even speak English.
Prejudice. Don't pass it on. Together, we can make a world of difference.
My ethnicity was never an issue. I grew up with and went to school with Polish boys and girls from kindergarten through 12th grade. However, when I got to college, it occurred to me that my Polish name was a problem. It probably wasn't, but I perceived that I was being discriminated against and that most people with whom I came in contact couldn't spell or pronounce Kukiewicz. And so I became obsessed with the idea of doing something about it. I took a phone book and went through the A's and B's and got almost through the C's and stumbled upon Curtis. I took the name, I used it in radio and television. I eventually changed my name legally and I just went with the name Curtis from that day forward to my everlasting regret.
Millions of viewers tune in to primetime specials, like this one, centering on ethnic humor.
Hi, how are you? Hi, how are you? Hi, how are you? I usually have problems doing my act, you know, because I know a lot of you white people never seen an Indian do stand-up comedy before, you know. Like, for so long, you probably thought that Indians never had a sense of humor, you know? We never thought you were too funny, either. I went to Custer Memorial Junior High, you know? And,
pretty funny. Or was it? Tonight, we find out how it feels when the joke's on you.
Primetime specials also examine the complex and sometimes painful issue of race relations.
Genji, I never saw you as a Japanese.
Well, I am. Look at me. This is Japanese, Japanese American. If you don't see this, you don't see nothing. Welcome to a
world. Children's programming is a vital part of our campaign.
Gathering tales from near and far. If you believe in...
The book calls it the Island of the Skog. It says, population one Skog. But it doesn't say what a skog is.
If there's only one, then there's plenty of room for all of us, said Louise. Why don't we bring it a gift so it will know we're friendly?
Wait a minute, Flubberhead, snapped Bouncer. Suppose this skog is dangerous. Let's blaze our way to the island and show him we mean business.
And television programs target the most impressionable Americans, our teenagers. To create lasting change, A World of Difference focuses on children. The classroom becomes a powerful workshop.
They teach sex education. As inadequate as it is, they do address the issue of girls and boys have to deal with each other sexually, and they talk about that. We need race education. We need ethnic education.
A World of Difference provides educators with a comprehensive resource guide featuring units on American beliefs and values, prejudice, stereotyping and discrimination, and scapegoating and racism. Educators in each community develop additional units that trace local ethnic histories and address community concerns. Intensive training helps teachers incorporate these lessons into existing curricula.
And if you really believe in equality, then you can't stay out of the arena. If you really believe in equality, you can't sit on the sideline.
As a result of these conferences and seeing so many people involved, so many teachers involved, it just makes you want to do more.
Everybody's prejudiced, and I think the more you get aware of how you are and start thinking about it, as a teacher you bring that in.
I think that the World of Difference campaign is something that will assist teachers. It's showing us a way to tackle a very difficult subject.
In major cities across the country, newspapers print special supplements containing feature articles and lessons on diversity. These are donated to the schools. Thousands of students participate in essay and poster contests, with winning entries featured on air and in print. All of these efforts, creative and participatory, provide teachers with valuable resources to create a lasting positive effect on young minds. In the upper grades, specially designed mini dramas are used to stimulate thinking about prejudice and stereotyping.
Hey, did you notice that?
What?
The two black guys in a Toyota.
That's unusual, isn't it?
Sure is around here. I just want to check in the car just to be safe.
You call it in, I'll check it out.
Anything I can do for you guys?
No, that's okay.
You live around here?
No, we don't.
Will you please get out of the car?
Why?
Please, get out of the car.
Do you have some identification?
Why are you parked here?
Look, officer, my son and I are just waiting for someone. What's the problem?
No problem.
Car's fine.
Okay, just a routine check.
Yeah, routine.
What's he getting upset about?
I don't know. No harm done.
We should report them.
For what?
I don't know.
Hey, forget it. It does make you mad, though, doesn't it? I guess they just wanted to know why we were here.
I didn't know we needed a reason.
These video tools trigger classroom discussion and learning.
This exercise on stereotypes is run by social studies teacher Lorraine Wachtel. What students are trying to do is to match personality traits and occupations with various ethnic groups. Look at what happens.
The Irish Catholic, and he likes to party.
Queens houses.
Queens.
Hispanic.
Is Hispanic.
And has a series of women lovers.
Garment worker. Jewish. And he's very religious.
Many of the students attributed time-honored stereotypes to each racial group. For instance, Irish are alcoholics, black and Hispanic women clean house and have a series of live-in lovers, Asians are honor students who play the violin, and Jews are religious and overly concerned about money.
You always picture a Jewish person to be somebody who goes to school all the time and wants money and saves all their money. That's it, you know? You don't picture them to do anything else but that.
You don't picture them partying.
The one with the business problems, nobody said he might be black or that, you know, the ones with the business problems are never
black. Well, everybody knows that a black person couldn't possibly own a business.
Yeah, that's what society makes it out to be like that.
All of these materials have an application not only in the classroom, but in the community at large, with seminars for civic and community leaders, law enforcement and fire officials, and corporate employees. The results of the training are exponential. Each person who participates becomes an ambassador against prejudice, encouraging others to understand and appreciate our cultural differences. They further the goal of the Anti-Defamation League, making the world a better place for people of difference to learn and live together.
Some have said, down through history, if you last, it's a mystery. But I guess they don't know what they're talking about. From the mountains down to the sea, you become such a habit with me. America, America. And my brothers are all black and white, yellow too. And the red man is right to expect a little from you. Promise and then follow through.
After more than 200 years, our strength is our diversity. Together, we can make a world of difference.